Hi everyone, I'm Sue from Create with Sue. Welcome. Today I'm sharing some important updates about the latest version of Canvas Workspace. That's version 2.6.3 of the downloaded version. So it's not the online one, it's the downloaded version that you install onto your computer. If you're a ScanNCut user, stick around because there's a bit of good, a bit of huh, and a touch of wait, where did that go? First up, a quick heads up for Mac users. This update officially drops support for Mac OS 12 and earlier. So if you're still running an older version, this may affect your ability to use Canvas Workspace moving forward. So if your Mac's a little more vintage and chic, it may be time for an upgrade or to perhaps avoid updating Canvas Workspace. In this video, I'll show you what's changed, demo the new duplication shortcut, and share a few ideas on how we'll survive without the ruler, because yes, we will probably survive. Let's jump in and explore the good, the glitchy, and the gone in version 2.6.3. So let's start by opening up Canvas Workspace. So I'm in the downloaded version of Canvas Workspace, and to make sure you're on version 2.6.3 or whether you need to update, you go up to the help and you go to about Canvas Workspace. Right there, and that'll pop up a box for you and you can see version 2.6.3. If you're on a Mac, I think you'll just go to the about, it just says about, not about Canvas Workspace. So once you've confirmed your version, just go OK. And you can actually check your updates there if you need to update. I have mine set so it automatically notifies me of an update, but you can just check that manually and that'll update. So let's go to the artboard next. On the right, you'll see your tools. And this one down here is the artboard. You can see it pops out as artboard. We'll click on that, and first thing we notice is the ruler has gone. Yep, it's quietly disappeared. Bit of a nuisance. It used to live just here. So it was just there on the right. You can see I've put a circle around it. So hopefully this is just a temporary glitch. For now, we'll just find a few workarounds, which I'll cover shortly. But here's something new and useful. You'll see the new shiny duplicate button, which is down here. I'll just scroll down in here. To activate it, you need to pop a shape onto your mat. So we're just gonna pick a square, pop a square there, shut that back down so you can see. And you'll see that this section has activated. On the left here is the new duplicate. You hold your mouse over it and it will show you duplicate. And I've got my square selected and click on it. And then it will just duplicate. Duplicates pretty easily, doesn't it? It'll just keep moving it down the page. Actually makes quite a pretty design, doesn't it? We'll go file and new. And I'll just make that bigger again. We'll use a few tips for working without that ruler. So one of the first tips is these grid lines. They're actually very handy. I use them quite a bit for aligning font bottoms and just in general things that might be a bit, you can't just use the alignment tools for basically, because you have got the alignment tools over here on the right, which will, they've got the bottom section. I'll just pop a square on because always everything works a bit better with a shape activated. Probably needs two shapes created. So if we select those two shapes, the alignment tools come alive and you could align them at the bottom or alignment at the top. I'll just separate them again and they both need to be selected. So they're one way of using it. You can use, if you've got wording, so you've got three different sizes there. So if you use the alignment tool for these, even if you use the middle, may not be quite how you want it because the Y is, I'll just zoom in a little bit more. The Y is not friendly. So using these tools, you could put your J on the top there, your O, and then your Y. And you've aligned them just by using this. You can also change your grid size. So at the moment, mine's on 1 inch. I like 1 inch, but you can, if you're working in millimeters, it'd be 25.4. I swap and change between inches and millimeters all the time. Because the spacing, you can change. You can just make it smaller. So if you have lots of objects that need a little bit of more intricate spacing, you can use that. Or you can make it bigger if you don't need it quite so small. I'll just zoom out so you can see the big, quite big. This works with any objects. I'm using lettering because lettering is one that has a high and a low point that are not necessarily on the center, bottom, or top. So the alignment tools often don't work with lettering. And also don't forget, you have your sizing boxes over here in the edit panel. Got the size box where you can see what size an object is. So that Y, for example, is 0.78 of an inch, and its width is 0.61. If you join them all together as one object, you'll see they're 1.62 and 1.16 high. Change that, you can see it changes the size. So if you know what size you want, that will work. The other thing I often do too, and I didn't, I've just recently done a video on using templates. So if you've got, this was in my sticker video, go and check it out. If you've got a lot of something that you want a particular size, create a template. So that square, to say something you wanted as a 2 inches, create your square as 2 inches. So there's your 2 inches there, and then go in and lock it down. So you do that in the layers panel, and I've got that shape highlighted. So that's this shape here, and here is a lock. Toggle the lock on. That does not move now. And if you are making a design, whatever it is, just say you want to bring a triangle in, and you want everything 2 inches or to fit inside a 2 inch square, you can use that little template to size it and then move your object to where you need it. Okay, so that's a quick look at what's changed and what's mysteriously missing in Canvas Workspace 2.6.3. I hope the duplication shortcut speeds up your workflow, and fingers crossed the ruler makes a comeback, because I've already heard people saying, oh, I missed my ruler. If you found this video helpful, give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more Scan and Cut tips, tricks, and tutorials. If you've got any questions or clever ruler workarounds that I haven't mentioned of your own, drop them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.